Today, I want to discuss about valuation of goodwill under average profit method. Okay, this is the example one. A business concern had earned profits for the past 5 years as follows. In the year of 2010, rupees 40,000 profit earned business A. 2011, 45,000. 2012, 48,000. 2013, 52,000. 2014, 45,000. So these are all the profits in 5 years of business concern, right? The goodwill of the firm is to be calculated at twice the average of the 5 years. This is the most important one. Goodwill is equal to twice the average of 5 years profits. Twice, that means two. Twice the average of 5 years profits. Goodwill is equal to twice the average of 5 years profits. Calculate the valuation of goodwill. This is the problem one. Very, very, very easiest problem. Okay. Look at the board, please. Goodwill is equal to twice the average of 5 years profits. That means 2 years into average profit. Right. Year profits. Year profits. 2010, 40,000. 2011, company earns profit 45,000. 2012, 48,000. 2013, 52,000. 2014, 45,000. Okay, the company earns in the year of 2010, 40,000, 2011, 45,000, 2012, 48,000, 2013, 52,000, 2014, the company earns 45,000. Total profits in the 5 years, okay, of the company is 2,30,000. Total profits in 5 years, 2,30,000. So average profit is equal to total of profits by number of years. That is equal to 2,30,000 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 years. 2,30,000 by 5 years. That is equal to 46,000. Okay. 2,30,000. Total of the profits in 5 years. 2,30,000. Number of years, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is equal to 5 years. That's why average profit is equal to 46,000. Okay. Then goodwill is equal to, twice the average of 5 years profits. That is equal to 2 into twice 2, average profit. How much? 46,000. That is equal to 92,000 rupees. The goodwill amount is equal to 92,000 rupees. So this is the simple problem in goodwill. Once again, I am telling that valuation of goodwill under average profit method. Okay. So this is the first one. It is first exercise problem, a simple problem. A business concern had earned profits for the past 5 years as follows. 2010 40,000, 11 45,000, 12 48,000, 13 52,000, 14 45,000. Right, the goodwill of the firm is to be calculated at twice the average of 5 years profits. Twice the average of 5 years profits. Calculate the value of goodwill. Goodwill is equal to twice the average of 5 years profits. Year profits. Okay, 2010 and 40,000 profit. 2011, 45,000. 2012, 48,000. 2013, 52,000. 2014, 45,000. Okay, total of profits in 5 years, 2,30,000. Total of profits in 5 years, 2,30,000. Therefore, average profit is equal to total of profits in 5 years by number of years. 2,30,000 by 5 years is equal to 46,000. Therefore, goodwill is equal to twice the average of 5 years profits. 2 into 46,000, 92,000 rupees. Goodwill, that value of goodwill is equal to 92,000 rupees. Next one. The next exercise, exercise 2. The profits of a firm was as follows. Okay, year amount 2011. Okay, company earns 40,000 profit before the adjustments. 2012 rupees 30,000. 2013 60,000. Okay, in the year of 2011, company earns a profit of rupees 40,000. 2012, 30,000. 2013, 60,000. Okay. Non-recurring income of rupees 4,000 is included in the year of 2011. So, 4 rupees non-recurring income included in the year of 2011 profit. That means rupees 4,000 non-recurring income included in 40,000. Okay, non-recurring income must be deducted from the in the 40,000 rupees profit for the year of 2011. Next one, goods worth of rupees 6,000 were destroyed in fire accident which took place in the year 2012. The godown was not insured. That's why rupees 6,000 goods worth destroyed in a fire accident. That's why rupees 6,000 worth of goods destroyed in fire accident. So rupees 30,000. Okay, rupees 6,000 deducted from 30,000. Next one, profits of 2013 was include rupees 5,000 income from investments. Okay, so in the year of 2013 profits 60,000, rupees 5,000 income included. So these are all the transactions must be deducted from the profits. First of all, calculated the actual value of profits here. Next one, calculate goodwill on the basis of 2 years purchase of average profits. 2 years purchase of average profits. So goodwill is equal to 2 years purchase of average profits, right? Year actual profits, profits year 2011 40,000 minus non-recurring income included 4,000 rupees. Okay, included 4,000 rupees included in the year of 2011 profits. So 40,000 minus 4,000, that is equal to 36,000. Next one, in the year of 2012, profits 30,000, 6,000 goods were destroyed in fire accident. Okay, that's why 30,000 minus 6,000, 24,000. Next one, in the year of 2013 profits, 60,000. Okay, 60,000, 5,000 income from investments included in 60,000 rupees profit. So 5,000. That's why 60,000 minus 5,000, 51,000. Okay, that is 55,000. That's why 2011 profits 36,000, 2012 profits 24,000, 2012 profits 55,000. Okay, total is total is 1,15,000. Therefore, average profit 1,15,000 by number of years, 3 years, that is equal to 38,333. So the average profits for 3 years, average profit is equal to 38,333. Next one, goodwill. Goodwill is equal to 2 into 2 years purchase of average profits. 2 into 38,333, that is equal to 76,666 rupees. Goodwill, value of goodwill is equal to 76,666. Okay, once again I am telling that in the year of 2011 profits, worth of rupees 4,000 income, non-recurring income included. That's why 40,000 minus 4,000, that is equal to 36,000. Next, goods worth rupees 6,000 were destroyed in fire accident. That's why 30,000 minus 60,000, 24,000. Next one, profits of 2013 included rupees 5,000 income from investments. Okay, income from investments included in 60,000 rupees. So 60,000 minus 5,000, that is equal to 55,000. Okay, total value of profits in 3 years 1,15,000, right? average profits is equal to 1,15,000 by 3 years. That is equal to 38,333. Right. Goodwill is equal to, what is the value of goodwill? Goodwill is equal to 2 years purchase of average profits. 2 × 38,333. That is equal to 76,666 rupees value of goodwill. Okay, this is the easiest problem for valuation of goodwill under average profit method. Okay, another example problem. A business concern had earned profits and losses for the past 4 years as follows. Okay, year 2004, annual profit of rupees 15,000. 2005, annual profit of rupees 18,000. In 2006, loss 2,000. In 2007, annual profit of rupees 22,000. Okay. The goodwill of the firm is to be calculated at twice the average of, look at the board please, twice the average of 2 years profits. Twice the average of 2 years profits. Let us see. First, how to be considered profits. Profits year and rupees. In the year of 2004, 15,000. In the year of 2005, 18,000. 2007, here we are only considered profits. Okay, 22,000. Total profits earned in 3 years, 55,000. Okay, loss 2006, 2,000. Total profits, okay, and in 4 years. Total profits and in 4 years, 53,000. Therefore, average profits is equal to 53,000 divided by 4 years. That is equal to 13,250 rupees. Therefore, goodwill is equal to, what is the value of goodwill? Goodwill is equal to twice the average of 2 years profits. Goodwill is equal to twice the average of 2 years profits. That's why 2 × 13,250. That is equal to 26,500. The value of goodwill is equal to 26,500. Okay, this is the value of goodwill under average profits method. Okay, example 4, valuation of goodwill under super profits method. Valuation under super profits method. Okay, a business concern had earned profits. A business concern had earned profit for past 3 years as follows. 2011, rupees 50,000. 2012, earned profits rupees 60,000. 2013, earned profits rupees 70,000. The average capital employed in the business rupees 40,000. Average capital employed in the business rupees 40,000. Okay, reasonable rate of return expected in a similar business 10%. Reasonable rate of return expected in the business, okay, 10%. Goodwill, calculate goodwill, 4 years purchase of super profits on the basis of average profit of 3 years. On the basis of average profit of 3 years. First of all, what is the principle for super profits? This is the principle for super profits. Super profit is equal to average profit minus normal profit. Super profit is equal to average profit minus normal profit. Normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Once again, I am telling, calculate goodwill, 4 years purchases of super profits. 4 years purchases, 4 years purchases of super profits on the basis of average of 3 years. So super profit is equal to, first how to be calculated super profit. For calculation of super profits, okay, the following principles to be applied. Super profit is equal to average profit minus normal profit. Normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Right, first you have to be calculated the super profit. So first, average profit in the year of 2011 50,000, 2012 60,000, 2013 70,000. Profits 2011 50,000, 12 60,000, 13 70,000. Total 1,80,000. So average profit. Average profit is equal to 1,80,000 by number of years 1, 2, 3. 3 years, that is equal to average profit 60,000 rupees. Next one, normal profit. Normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Look at the board, please. Average capital employed in the business 40,000. Reasonable rate of return, normal rate of return is equal to 10%. So what is the principle for normal profit? Capital employed into normal rate of return. That's why 40,000 into 10/100, that is equal to 4,000 rupees. So average profit 60,000, normal profit 4,000. Super profit is equal to average profit minus normal profit. Average profit is equal to 60,000. Normal profit minus normal profit, how much? 4,000. then super profit is equal to then super profit is equal to 56,000. Therefore, goodwill is equal to, what is the value of goodwill? 4 years purchases of super profits. 4 years purchases of super profits. That is equal to 4 into super profit per year, 56,000. So 4 into 56,000, 2,24,000. This is the value of goodwill. Once again, I am telling that valuation of goodwill under super profits method. Valuation of goodwill under super profits method. Okay. So, a business concern had profit for the profit past 3 years as follows. In the year of 2011, earned rupees 50,000 profit. 2012, 60,000. 2013, 70,000. Average capital employed in the business, rupees 40,000. Reasonable rate of return expected in a similar business, 10%. Calculate goodwill, 4 years purchases of super profits on the basis of average of 3 years profits. Okay, goodwill is equal to 4 years purchases of super profits. Super profit, how can be calculated super profits? Super profit is equal to average profit minus normal profit. Okay. We know very well how we can calculate, how we are calculated average profits. Profits for the total of years by number of years. Okay. Next, normal profit. Normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Okay. First, average profit. 2011 50,000, 12 60,000, 13 70,000. Total profits in 3 years 1,80,000. Therefore, average profit is equal to 1,80,000 by 3 years 60,000. Next one, normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Right, normal profit is equal to capital employed 40,000, normal rate of return 10%, 4,000, 60,000 minus 4,000, 56,000 super profit. So, goodwill is equal to 4 years purchases of super profits. That's why 4 years into 56,000. 2,34,000. So, this is the way of calculation of goodwill under super profits. Okay, let us see the next problem for valuation of goodwill under super profits method. From the following information, calculate the value of goodwill. Average capital employed in business, rupees 40,000. Net trading profits of firm for the past 4 years. 2010, 12,200, 11, 11,000, 12, 2,000, 13, 21,000. Rate of interest expected from capital, 10%. Fair remuneration to the service of Samson, rupees 3,600. 3 years purchases of super profits on the basis of average profits of previous 4 years be treated as goodwill. So, goodwill is equal to 3 years purchases of super profits. 3 years purchases of super profits. Super profits is equal to average profit minus fair remuneration to the service of Samson minus normal profits. This is the new point. Actually, we are calculated for the super profits is equal to average profits minus normal profits. So, additional information is available. So, that one is fair remuneration to the services of Samson in this problem. That's why super profits is equal to average profit minus fair remuneration to the service of Samson minus normal profit. We are using this principle for calculation of super profits in this problem. So first, step one, calculation of average profits. Calculation of average profits. Year, rupees. Years, 2010, 12,200. In the year of 2011, 11,000. In the year of 2012, 2,000. In the year of 2013, 21,000. And the profits. So the profits for 4 years. $46,400. Okay. The profits in 4 years. Okay. The total profits in 4 years. $46,200. Then average profits is equal to 46,200 by 4 years. That is equal to 11,550 rupees is to be treated as average profits. Okay. Super profit is equal to average profit minus fair remuneration to the service of Samson minus normal profit. So average profit 11,250 minus remuneration to the service of Samson. How much amount paid? 3,600 minus remuneration. How much? 3,600. Then 7,950 minus normal profits. What is the principle for calculation of normal profits? Normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Capital employed 40,000 into normal rate of return. How much? 10%. 10/100. That is equal to 4,000. Then 3,950 rupees is to be treated as super profits. Next, goodwill is equal to 3 years purchases of super profits. That's why 3 years into 3,950, that is equal to 11,850 rupees is to be treated as goodwill. Look at the problem, please. Super profits method. Calculation of goodwill under super profits method, we are using the following principle. Super profits is equal to average profits minus normal profits actually. But a new point is available. The remuneration is also be paid for Samson in this problem. Okay, that's why super profit is equal to average profit minus fair remuneration to the service of Samson minus normal profit. Goodwill is equal to 3 years purchases of super profits. 3 years purchases of super profits. For calculation of three super profits, so the following procedure is required. First, step one, calculation of average profit. Average profit is equal to total profits of 4 years divided by number of years. Total profits in 4 years, 46,200. Okay, by number of years, 4 years, 46,200 divided by 4 years, that is equal to 11,550 less remuneration to the services of Samson, 3,600. Then, what is the value? 7,950 minus normal profit. Normal profit is equal to capital employed into normal rate of return. Capital employed, how much? 40,000. Normal rate of return into normal rate of return, 10%. So normal profit is equal to 40,000 into 10 by 100, 4,000. Then super profit is equal to 3,950. Okay, goodwill is equal to 3 years purchases of super profits. 3 years purchases of super profits. So goodwill is equal to 3 years into 3,950. That is equal to 11,850. So this is also a problem in super profits method. Calculation of goodwill under super profits method.